सदाशिव समारंभा शंकराचार्य मध्यमा अस्मदाचार्य पर्यंता वंदे गुरु परंपरा श्रुति श्रुति पुराणानां आलय करुणालय नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं वाजरायणं सूत्र भाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माणो विदाति कुरु वेदाश्च प्रणोतिस्मितं हृदयमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुरुहै शरणमहं प्रपञ्चे। शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। श्रीचिद्घनगणेश नमोमयं सुखनित्यं सत्प्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूपाधिष्ठानं बुद्ध्यबोध्यं बुद्धेर्दृक्यत्यनिर्वपारं सर्ववेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं तदेवाहन्नमत्तो नियन्ति मे निश्चिता मतिः। महावाक्य एनालिसिस एज टू व्हाट इज लक्षण। सो वी सॉ संबंध इज वृत्ति, संबंध बिटवीन पद एंड पदार्थ, दैट संबंध इज कॉल्ड एज वृत्ति। इट इज ऑफ टू टाइप, शक्ति एंड लक्षण। तयो स्वरूपम सलक्षण वर्ण्यमानम श्रुणु इति गुरु अवदत्। गुरु सेड दैट आई विल टॉक अबाउट लक्षण इन जनरल and then talk about each of these three types of lakshanas. Before that, we have to understand why lakshana is needed, because shakti of the shabda pada, which reveals the meaning, that is contradictory in the case of mahavakya. So the direct meaning by the pada shakti leads to contradiction in understanding that Ishvara is you. The Tippana explains this in detail as to what is the Shakti. Shabdagatai yat swarthavabodhana samarthyam tadeva shabdasya shakti hiti varnyate. What is the Shakti? Samarthyam shakti hi. So shabdasya shakti, the shakti within the shabda is that which is its capacity, samarthyam, shabdagatam yat samarthyam, within the shabda, that samarthya, capacity to lead to bodhana, avabodhana of swasya artha, swartha. So swartha avabodhana samarthyam tadeva shabdasya shaktihi. So the capacity to reveal the meaning, its own meaning, is called as shabda shaktihi. Sa shakti rupa vrittihi kapala dvayam madhyasthita kapala sanyogavat karya karanatmaka padartha dvaya madhyasthita samavaya sambandhavat athava tadatmya sambandhavaccha shabdartha yor madhye asti. Between the shabda and artha, there is this shakti called as vritti. So shakti rupa vritti is there, which is the connection between pada and padartha. So here it is said that these are the sambandha is of various types. So kapala dvaya madhya sthita kapala sanyogavat. So the shakti which reveals the meaning when you hear the word, that is like the connection between the two, the sanyoga between the two kapalas in the ghata. So two kapalas are joined to make a ghata. So that conjunction, when you join these two, it is like that, the shakti is like that, which will connect the two, pada and padartha. Or in karya and karana, between karya and karana there is some sambandha. So karya karanatmaka padartha dvaya madhya sthita samavaya sambandhavat. There is a sambandha. Sambandha, what kind of sambandha? Samavaya sambandha. There is a particular kind of sambandha called as samavaya sambandha, which is between karya and karana, ityadi. There are other types of samavaya sambandhas also. other places also where there is samavaya sambandha, guna guni, or there is a tadatmya sambandha, identification. This tadatmya sambandha also is a connection. So in Vedanta, the tadatmya sambandha is different from the way others may interpret it, but tadatmya sambandha is the sambandha of identification. Saha atma yasya, that will be tadatma and tasya bhava tadatmyam. So tadatmya sambandha vachya shabdartayor madhya asti. This sambandha is there, which is between the pada and padartha. It is similar to these examples given. That shakti, which is what? Sambandha rupa shakti, also called as vritti, one type of vritti is this shakti. The other is lakshana. So this is what the capacity to reveal the direct meaning. When you hear a word, the meaning that is revealed, that is called as the shabda gata shakti. It is there within the shabda itself. Tasmat saayam shakti hi shabdasya arthena sa vidyamana shakti vritti rupa sakshat sambandho bhavati. It's a direct sambandha. And thereby the shakti reveals the direct meaning. Iyam cha sakshat sambandha rupa shakti vritti hi yogaha rudhi yoga rudhi iti trividha. This shakti, the capacity to reveal the meaning, is also of three types, which is what the word has. So the word reveals the meaning by yoga rudhi or yoga rudhi. What is yoga? Generally, yoga is the technical derivation that we learn in Vyakrana. Rudhi is the rudhyartha, what we call as rudhyartha, meaning this is the meaning. If you look at the dhatu, if you reverse engineer the word and land on the dhatu, try to understand the dhatu meaning and try to understand the pratyaya meaning and try to bring out the overall meaning, you may not land on it. Rudhyartha is something else. So the word will reveal the meaning which is not there in the dhatu pata and the pratyaya. So that is rudhi artha. This is also shakti within that particular word. Yoga rudhi is the yogic artha is also applicable. Rudhi artha also is applicable. But yogic artha may give so pratyaya to a particular dhatu. Dhatu has a particular meaning, and when you add a pratyaya, based on what kind of yutpatti the pratyaya allows, you may get multiple meanings, multiple karaka arthas say. But yoga rudhi says forces a particular meaning only. Although the yogika meaning is also applicable, rudhi artha will supersede. Rudhi artha is baliyan. Between the yoga artha, yogika artha and rudhi artha is always to be preferred, overrides the other. So there yoga rudhi is the shakti which reveals that particular meaning only. Other meanings may be there, but the first meaning that strikes you is the rudhyartha. So these are the three types of shaktis. Yasya shabdasya svavaya yogena melanena artha jnanutpadana samarthyam asti tasya shabdasya swarthena sa yoga shakti rupah sambandha asti. Sa sambandha eva shabdasya yoga vrittiriti varnyate. I have explained the overview here itself. So we look at the example here. Yatha pada raksha iti pade, pada raksha iti avayava dvayam asti. So in a samasa, pada raksha is the word. So pada raksha padam, when you hear that, it's a samasa, so it's a compounded word, declines in strilinga as pada raksha. When you hear pada raksha, pada has one meaning, raksha has another meaning. There are these two individual words which have come together in a compound. So pada raksha iti avayava dvayam asti. There are two parts in the compound, two words. Tayor dvayor avayor yogena kantakadibhya padatrana yogyopadanadi rupartasya jnanam jayate. Then when you hear this pada raksha, what comes to mind? You know what pada is? You know what raksha is? When you say pada raksha, the meaning that comes to mind is that which protects from the thorns, etc. on the road. Thereby the footwear meaning is very clear. Pada raksha. that which protects your feet. तस्मात् पादरक्ष इति पदस्य पादरक्षण योग्योपादानादि रूप तदर्थेन स योगशक्ति रूप संबंध अस्ति. सो द मीनिंग दैट इज रिवीलिंग दैट इज थ्रू द शक्ति संबंध. सो दिस इज योग शक्ति रूप संबंध. देयर इज अ कनेक्शन पाद रक्षण योग्योपादानादि रूप तदर्थेन सह पदस्य पादरक्ष इति पदस्य. सो दिस पादरक्ष पद हैज द कनेक्शन विद द अर्थ. व्हाट काइंड ऑफ अर्थ? पादरक्षण योग्य उपादानादि रूप तदर्थेन सह योग शक्ति रूप संबंध इज देयर. देयर बाय इट रिवील्स द मीनिंग. यस्य पदस्य अर्थज्ञानम् अवयवैर् न जायते किन्तु अस्य पदस्य अयमेव अर्थः इत्येवं पदार्थबोधनविषयकसंकेतो परिभाषायस्य संकेतो यस्य दैट्स द संधि संकेतः परिभाषा. अदरवाइज इफ यू रीड द वर्ड इन द ब्रैकेट आल्सो संकेतः परिभाषायस्य पदस्य येन अर्थेन अस्ति तस्य पदस्य तेन अर्थेन सह रूढिशक्तिरूप संबंधो अस्ति. सो रूढ़ी शक्ति रूप संबंध इज दैट संबंध विच रिवील्स द मीनिंग ऑफ द वर्ड व्हेन यू हियर द वर्ड विच इज नॉट नोन अदरवाइज थ्रू द कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ द वर्ड्स. स एव संबंध शब्द से रूढ़ी वृत्ति इति अभिधीयते. दैट संबंध विच इज शक्ति रूप रूढ़ी शक्ति रूप दैट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज रूढ़ी वृत्ति. यथा उष्णीशः इति पदस्य अवयवेभ्यः न कस्यापि अर्थस्य बोधो जायते किन्तु उष्णीशः इति पदात् शिरोवेष्टन रूपोऽर्थः लोके संकेतपूर्वकं ज्ञायते. सो शिरोवेष्टन टर्बन. सो उष्णीशः हैज द मीनिंग ऑफ अ टर्बन. अनलेस यू नो दिस वर्ड एज इन द मीनिंग ऑफ द टर्बन यू कैनॉट एनालाइज द components of Ushnisha and land on the meaning. So you have to know the Rudi Artha there, and that is the capacity of the word to reveal the meaning. But the individual components do not lead to the meaning of the term of a turban. Tathacha Ushnisha dasya शिरोवेष्टन रूपार्थेन सह रूढ़िशक्ति रूप संबंध अस्ति. सो दिस उष्णीश पदस्य दिस इज एक्चुअली नॉट यदस्य तथा च उष्णीश पदस्य शिरोवेष्टन रूपार्थेन सह रूढ़िशक्ति रूप संबंध अस्ति. दैट्स अ टाइपो देयर. सो हाउ डज द उष्णीश पद कनेक्ट विद द शिरोवेष्टन रूप अर्थ द टर्बन मीनिंग ऑफ द ऑफ टर्बन through the Rudi Shakti Rupa Sambandha called as Rudi Vritti. Yasya padasya avayavaihi yasya arthasya bodho jayate tasya tasmin arthe laukika sanketo apyasti tasya padasya tena arthena sa yoga rudhi iti uhaya. So yoga and rudi, this is also typo. So yoga and rudi both through yoga as well as rudi, meaning through derivation through parts of the word as well as through the Rudi Artha, if the same meaning is revealed, then it is Yoga Rudhi. Yatha Anga Raksha. When you hear Anga Raksha, you know the meaning of Anga, you know the meaning of Raksha. So Anga Raksha, which Anga? So if you say every Anga, so Pada is also an Anga. Here Pada Raksha we heard, Pada is also an Anga. So Anga Raksha does not have the meaning of Pada Raksha though. Although it can be technically the meaning because Pada is also an Anga, but Anga Raksha does not have the meaning of footwear. But Anga Raksha has the meaning of armor. Thereby Rudi Artha is there, and the armor which protects the body, Anga also means body, thereby Rudi Artha and Yogika Artha both fit in there. So it has a capacity to reveal a particular meaning through Rudi as well as through Yoga. Therefore, the Vritti is Yoga Rudi Vritti. और शक्ति इज योग रूढ़ी शक्ति, बोथ आर एप्लीकेबल हियर. सो अंग रक्षा इति अवयवद्वयमस्ति, तयोर योगेन चोल कुंचुक इत्यर्थस्य ज्ञानं भवति. पादरूपांगस्य रक्षणकर्त्रीं पादुकां बोधयितुं अंगरक्षा पदं न प्रयुञ्जीत, किन्तु चोल रूप अर्थम और कंचुक रूप अर्थम बोधयितुं एव इदं पदं प्रयुञ्जीत. अस्मिन् कंचुक रूपे अर्थे अंगरक्षापदस्य लौकिक संकेतो अप्यस्ति, तस्मात् अंगरक्षापदस्य स्वार्थेन कंचुकेन स योगरूढिरित्य उभय रूप शक्ति संबंधो अस्ति. So the example is very clear there as to yogika artha and rudhi artha, both are valid. Other example, common one is what? Pankajadi padamatra prasiddho udharanam. So pankaja, pankaja is what? Pankejataha or pankajataha, panchami. So pankajataha or saptami also possible, which is more valid in the case of pankaja, that which is born in panka, so muddy waters. So pankaja has the meaning of lotus. So if you derive it through samasa vigraha vakya, you will get the same meaning. And pankaja rudhi artha is also lotus, therefore both fit in, and thereby yoga rudhi is the shakti there which reveals the meaning. सेम शब्दस्य त्रिविधा शक्ति वृत्ति मुख्य वृत्ति इत्युच्यते. नाउ ऑल दीज थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ शक्तिज और वृत्तिज विच आर बेसिकली संबंध बिटवीन दी पद एंड पदार्थ, सो दैट शक्ति विच इज द कैपेसिटी ऑफ द वर्ड टू रिवील द मीनिंग थ्रू योग रूढ़ी और योग रूढ़ी, ऑल दीज थ्री वेज इन विच द वर्ड रिवील्स द मीनिंग is what the direct meaning, reveals the direct meaning, that is called as mukhya vritti. So yoga rudhi as well as yoga rudhi shaktis vrittis are mukhya vrittis. Shabdasya shakti vritti roopa sambandha jayamana shabdasya sakshat sambandhi yuvartha sa shakyartha iti varnyate. Now this meaning revealed through this शक्ति वृत्ति, दैट इज कॉल्ड अस शक्यार्थः. सो द डायरेक्ट मीनिंग मुख्य वृत्ति रिवीलिंग द मीनिंग इज शक्यार्थः. सो नाउ इन द केस ऑफ महावाक्य यू हैव टू सी वेदर शक्यार्थः मेक सेंस और नॉट. नॉट इन द केस ऑफ महावाक्य ओनली, एनी वाक्य एनी पदा ऑल्सो वेन यू हियर वेदर the yoga rudhi or yoga rudhi, all three meanings reveal the direct meaning. If any of these are applicable, then we use those and understand the word, and then similarly the sentence also. If none of these three meanings make sense, none of these three can lead to a direct meaning which makes sense in that context, then you have to either bring in a context, has to connect a context based on Mimamsa, has to maybe there is some other section in Brahmana or in Mantra Bhaga where this particular sentence connects. If that also does not allow interpretation, then you have to do Lakshana. There is an implied meaning there, because Vedas cannot be talking about, especially in Vedas. Laukika also, in Laukika language also, this is how we use Lakshana, where direct meaning does not fit in, where Mukhya Vritti does not lead to Shakyartha, which makes sense there, then you have to use the Lakshana. So this is where it is leading now. Example given is, Yatha Pita iti Shabdasya Shakti Vritti Rupa Sakshat Sambandha Janaka Rupartena Savartate. So Pita means the father, however, contextually it has to be interpreted differently. तस्मात् पिता इति शब्दस्य शक्तिवृत्ति रूप संबंधेन ज्ञातुं योग्यः साक्षात् संबंधी च जनक रूपयार्थः स पितृ शब्दस्य शक्यार्थः इति कथ्यते. सो शक्यार्थः ऑफ द पिता शब्द पितृ शब्द डिक्लाइंड इन एनी ऑफ द विभक्तिज एंड वचनस is the father and that is the direct meaning. Shakyartha. Shakyartha sambandini vaktrutatparya visheibhute cha arthantare shabdasya parampara sambandha sa shabdasya lakshana vrittirityuchyate. However, शक्यार्थ संबंधिनी वक्तृतात्पर्य विषयीभूते च अर्थांतरे शब्दस्य या परंपरा संबंधः. There is a connection indirectly, not a direct connection, but the sambandha is paramparaya. There is some connected meaning which is revealed when the direct meaning is not revealed, or direct meaning does not make sense, then there is another sambandha, then you use that sambandha and interpret something. It cannot be a random meaning. The word has to have some connection with some other meaning indirectly. That indirection is through parampara of connections. It can be one of, it can be two of, or so on. So those who have studied Bhashya, they know how Bhagavan Bhashyakara or Tikas also following Bhagavan Bhashyakara lands on the final meaning stepwise. So he will give one meaning to the word, then give the meaning to the meaning given for that word, and then another meaning, and slowly he will land on the implied meaning finally. You cannot land on that directly. So there is a parampara sambandha. Arthantare, with another artha. Directly there is no meaning possible, but shakyartha, shakyartha sambandini vaktru tatparya visheyute. Tatparya is based on the vakta. So there is some tatparya, there is some vivaksha. So vivakshatah karakani. In Vyakarana it is said karakas used are based on vivaksha. Similarly, the meaning is as per the vivaksha. The vivaksha has to be understood to understand the meaning. What meaning will fit in? What did he really mean when he said this? So that time, tatparya has to be known. Tatparya linga is useful there to understand mahavakya. So they have a dependency. You have to know the whole to understand something which does not make sense using shakyartha. And once you made sense of a mahavakya kind of a statement which otherwise wouldn't make sense with shakyartha, you have used the lakshana based on the overall view, then everywhere you can use this mahavakya and land on the tatparya also. So there is a lot of interdependency. You have to understand shakyartha wherever it is possible, but while using lakshana, you have to have an overview. You have to have a bird's eye view of the shastra to use which lakshana where. Then all the tatparya lingas will lead to a right interpretation of the mahavakya, and other mahavakyas also will lead to the tatparya as well. So there are people who complain that Advaitins use this methodology and land on something where there is an interdependency. The interdependency is everywhere. You cannot understand the person saying something unless you know the context. So context has to be clear. So tatparya has to be known. Suddenly you land into some meeting and some discussion is going on. You don't know what the meeting is about. You don't know anyone. You cannot make any sense out of it just by hearing words and sentences. Words and sentences have particular meaning in particular context. The same statement made across context can mean completely different things. So there is definitely interdependency, and this interdependency is part of the language. It has nothing to do with an Advaitin interpreting the shastras differently. So anyway, that's an aside, but it's an important thing to notice that tatparya linga plays an important role to understand the context also, and once the context is understood, then for the overall interpretation also. So there is an interdependency. A lot of work goes in to make sense out of everything. Only then everything will make sense. So it is not only the first round, multiple rounds of study lead to the core understanding of the Shastra. Yatha Krutodvaham Mangalam Pitamaha Samipavartinam Pautram Prati Sarvebhya Purvam Pitaram Namaskuru Iti Aptavakyagatena Pita Iti Shabdena Pitamaha Bodhanam Lakshanavritya Bhavati. So in some, you know, ceremony, marriage ceremony or something, the groom is asked to do namaskara to the elders and then start with your father. This is what is said. However, the grandfather is also there. So when it is said starting with your father also, the groom has to do namaskara to the grandfather first, not the father first. So pita iti shabdasya pitamaha, that meaning will also apply. So when it is said pitamaha samipavartinam pautram prati sarvebhya puram pitaram namaskuru, you do namaskara to your father, start there. So he has to do namaskara to others also, other elders. But where does he start? He does not start with his father, because right next to him is his grandfather. So he has to start with the grandfather. Now the pita meaning sarvebhya puram pitaram namaskuru has been announced by the officiating priest, but this groom starts with his grandfather. How did this pita shabda, pitra shabda in dvitiya ekvachana pitaram, how did it have the meaning of pitamaha, pitamaham? So he landed on doing namaskara. He did namaskara to pitamaha. Why? Through this shakti rupa sambandha is there between the pitra shabda and his father, but there is lakshana rupa sambandha between pitra shabda and pitamaha. Pitamaha as a padartha, his grandfather. That is through lakshana vritti. Iti apta vakya gatena pita iti shabdena pitamaha bodhanam lakshana vrittya. Tatra shakyartha rupa janaka sambandini vaktru purusha tatparya vishayi bhute pitamaha rupaarthantare yah pitru shabdasya parampara sambandha sa pita iti shabdasya lakshana vrittihi. This is lakshana vritti, whereby he understands when he hears the word father, still he knows grandfather is included there. Through lakshana vritti, shabda has shakti which reveals the meaning father directly, but through lakshana vritti, implied meaning is also grandfather there. So anyway, that much should be sufficient here. There is quite a lot of discussion. I'll just quickly go through it. Tadrusha lakshana vritti bodhya shabdasya shakyartha dvara paramparaya sambandha ya artha sa shabdasya lakshartha ityuchyate. Then lakshartha is the implied meaning that you have landed on through lakshana vritti parampara. Yatha pita iti shabdasya shakyartha bhuta janaka dvara paramparaya sambandha yah pitamaha rupa artha sa pita iti shabdasya lakshartha. So pitru shabdasya pita iti, that pita is the shakyartha, but lakshartha is also pitamaha. Yasya shabdasya yena arthena sakshat sambandham vina eva anyadvara sambandho vartate tasya shabdena tena arthena sa parampara sambandha uchyate. So we understand this parampara sambandha. Sequentially there is some connection. It can be in multiple steps also. That parampara sambandha is what is lakshana. Tathai pautarupa tritiya purushasya pita mahatmaka prathama purushena saha saksha sambandhasya janya janaka bhavasya abhave api putrasya swapitra sa saksha janya janaka bhava sambandha asti pitushcha swapitra pitamahena saha sambandhu asti tasmat pautrasya pitamahena saha pitrudvara sambandhu asti ayameva parampara sambandha. So parampara sambandha is explained. The groom is connected to the pita with the janya janaka bhava sambandha, the parent child relation. Then another parent child relation or some other relation is there. between the father and the grandfather. Here it is janya janaka sambandha, but the father may be connected to someone else also, maybe uncle also. There is no janya janaka bhava sambandha, but there is an elder to the father also. So such sambandha may be there. That is the secondary sambandha. The primary sambandha here is primary and secondary. I am just using to differentiate. First or the first level sambandha is directly there between the pita shabda and his father, pitru shabda and pita. There is a shakti rupa sambandha which is revealing the direct meaning, and the pita is also there in the context. He can go and do namaskar to pita also. But there is second level of sambandha between paramparaya, between the father and the grandfather or the grand uncle. Thereby there is parampara, that paramparayameva parampara sambandha, and through that lakshanavritti can work. So when lakshanavritti is used, you cannot take some random meaning also. There has to be some sambandha. This sambandha is also analyzed. That is the tatparya in this example. Tathaiva shabdasya sakshat sambandhiya shakyartha tasmad anya shakyartha sambandhi cha yaha artha na tena sa sakshat sambandho asti. The first and the son has the direct sambandha with the father, and the father has the direct sambandha with grandfather. There is no direct sambandha like janya janaka bhava between the pautra and the pitamaha. Similarly, when you are analyzing shabda also, paramparaya shabda have sambandhas. In the implied meaning, there is no direct connection. Apitu shabdasya shakti rupa sambandha shakyarthena sa vartate. Shakyarthasya cha sanyogadi rupa yah kashchana sambandha. Vaktur tatpare visheyabhutena swasambandhena anyena arthena sa vartate. So shakyartha, the direct meaning, apitu shabdasya shakti rupa sambandha. Shakti rupa sambandha which is there between the shabda pada and padartha, which is there is shakyartha, there is a direct sambandha. But shakyarthasya sanyogadi rupa yah kashchana sambandha, it can be any sambandha between the shakyartha in the case of pita. Here shakyartha is pita. The pita is connected with pitamaha with a different sambandha, let's say. Some other sambandha. It can be any sambandha. Sanyogadi. When you looking at shabda though, there sanyogadi rupa sambandha may be there. Yah kashchana sambandha, whatever it be. The second level sambandha can be anything, but it can be the meaning of the word that you hear, although it is not a direct meaning. Vaktru tatpare visheyabhutena swasambandhena anyena arthena sa vartate. With another meaning, there is a presence of that meaning through some other connection. And that is the implied meaning based on what? Based on the tatparya of the speaker. Tasmat shabdasya swashakya sambandhi tasmat shabdasya swashakya sambandhina anyarthena saha shakyartha dvara sambandho asti. So the meaning, implied meaning, lakshana, lakshartha, which is the lakshartha, lakshana reveals lakshartha. What is the sambandha there, lakshana sambandha? Shakyartha dvara. It is through the shakyartha itself. You have to take the shakyartha, and that shakyartha has some sambandha with the lakshartha. And that sambandha is through lakshana sambandha. Atha eva sa parampara sambandha ityuchyate. So this is a sequential connection through which you land from the direct meaning, drop it and take the implied meaning. Shabdasya ayam eva parampara sambandha lakshana vritti. This parampara sambandha is lakshana vritti, is called as lakshana. Yasya shabdasya parampara sambandha yena arthena bhavati sa tasya shabdasya lakshartha. So यस्य शब्दस्य परंपरा संबंध येन अर्थेन सह भवति. सो येन अर्थेन शब्दस्य परंपरा संबंध भवति. देयर इज अ मीनिंग व्हिच इज थ्रू इनडायरेक्ट मीनिंग कनेक्टेड इन अ सीक्वेंस ऑफ स्टेप्स. इट कैन बी two steps or it can be three steps or more. So whatever is this parampara sambandha through which the implied meaning is revealed by a word or you land on it, that is the lakshyartha. So that is the shabdasya lakshyartha, you land on that. इत्थम लक्षणावृत्तेः सामान्य लक्षणम् उदाहरणं च उक्तम्. सो नाउ सामान्य लक्षण एंड उदाहरण हैज बीन गिवन ऑफ व्हाट इज दिस लक्षण, बिकॉज़ द शिष्य हैड आस्क्ड व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ लक्षण. फर्स्ट यू एक्सप्लेन दैट एंड देन प्लीज प्रोसीड टू गिविंग दी थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ लक्षणावृत्तीज एंड देन यू कैन टेल मी व्हाई दी अर्लियर टू वोंट वर्क एंड दी लास्ट वन भागत्याग लक्षण वुड वर्क इन द केस ऑफ महावाक्य. ज लक्षणादि त्रिविधम जलक्षणादि त्रिविध भेदोदाहरण उपरिष्टात् आवर्तन टिप्पण्यां वक्ष्यते. सो बिटवीन 430 एंड 432 दीस पर्टिकुलर लक्षणावृत्तीस एंड देयर एग्जांपल्स विल बी गिवन इन द मूल इटसेल्फ. सो बैक टू मूल, लेट मी सी व्हाट इज द टिप्पणा देयर. या नो टिप्पणा इन द नेक्स्ट पेज. So this was a long tika to understand what is shakti, what is lakshana. To summarize, vritti is of two types. Vritti is sambandha between the pada and padartha. It is of two types, shakti and lakshana. Shakti is the capacity of the word to reveal the meaning directly, either through derivation grammatically or through the meaning which is common in the language, so which is a common meaning well known to everyone called as Rudhi Artha. So Yogic Artha is the derived meaning, you know, through Vyakrana Shastra, Dhatu Patha Pratyaya, Samasa Vritti Ityadi. Then Rudhi Artha, which supersedes the Yogic Artha in most cases, generally, you know, Prayana. Then yoga and rudi, both are applicable. These are the three different ways in which the pada shakti reveals the padartha. That is called a shakti vritti, direct meaning. Lakshana vritti is through parampara sambandha. Shakyartha, which is the direct meaning, that has some other sambandha with some other padartha. That sambandha is called as lakshana sambandha and lakshana vritti. And what you land on, the padartha that you understand through the original word, which is not the direct meaning, which is through parampara sambandha, the meaning revealed is called as lakshyarthaha. So we have shakti, shakyarthaha leading to shakyartha, pada shakti. Then we have lakshana, through which you land on lakshyartha, the implied meaning. Tayo swarupam salakshanam varnyamanam shrunu iti guru ravadat. Now the definition of these are given in the following avartas. Shakti lakshanam, what is the lakshana definition of shakti? Nyayamatena shakti lakshanam, what does nayayika say? Nyaya vaisheshikas, what do they say about shakti? What is this shakti? घटः इति एतत् पदश्रवण मात्रेण सकल कलश रूपस्य अर्थस्य ज्ञानं सर्वेषां भवतु इति ईश्वर इच्छा एव न्यायशास्त्रे शक्तिरित्युच्यते. सो दे आर वेरी सिंपल वे टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज द शक्ति. सो देयर इज अ ईश्वर इच्छा. नैयायिका से ईश्वर हैज मेड दिस वर्ड्स टू हैव पर्टिकुलर मीनिंग्स. That Ishwara Ichha, that a particular word will reveal a particular meaning, that itself is called as Shakti. When does it reveal a meaning? When the word is heard. So iti ghata. So example is ghata. When you hear ghata, ghata iti etat padashravana matrena. By merely hearing the word ghata, sakala kalasharupasya arthasya jnanam sarvesham bhavatu. Let everyone have this jnana in their buddhi of that padartha called ghata, which is what? Sakala kalasha rupa. So whatever kind of pot, let those thoughts come to the mind, or when it is heard in singular, any kind of thought that a person knows, may that come into one's antakarana. This itself is the Ichcha of Ishvara, and that is itself called as Shakti. Padanishtam Artha Jnanotpadana Samarthyam Padashaktiriti Siddhante Shakti Lakshanam. However, Vedanta does not agree with this. Vedanta says Shakti is not Ishvara Ichcha. What is this Shakti, Padashakti? Padanishtam Artha Jnanotpadana Samarthyam. This capacity, samarthya, which we have seen in the Tippana elaborately, jnanotpadana samarthyam, the capacity to lead to jnanotpatti of that artha which is padanishtha itself, which is present in the word itself, it is hidden in the word, that is called as padashakti. This is Vedanta Siddhanta. That is the definition of Shakti, Shakti Lakshanam. Ghatapadam Shrunvataha Kalasharuparta Bodha Janana Anukulam Ghatapadanishtam Samarthyam Eva Ghatapadasya Shakti. It is not Ishvara Ichcha, it is that which is present in the Pada itself to reveal this meaning of Ghata. That, you know, Sakala Kalasha, it's okay, Sakala Kalasha comes to mind when you hear the word Ghata, but that is Padanishtha. It is present in the Ghata Pada itself. Evamev patapadam shrunvataha vastararuparta bodha jananukulam patapadanishtam samarthyam patapadasya shaktihi. Similarly, pata reveals, when you hear the word pata, cloth comes to mind, that is due to the shakti which is there in the pada pata itself, the word pata. Evamev sarvapadanam tattad artha bodha jananukulam tattat padanishtam samarthyam tattat padasya shakti riti jneyam. And this should be extended to each and every word. Each word has the capacity to reveal a meaning, that is called as padashakti. Atra drushtanta. And now example is given here in the moola. Yathavanne swasambandha padartha dahajanana samarthya rupa shakti rasti tatha shrutu shravanendriya sanyukta shabdasya स्वसंबंधार्थ ज्ञान जनन सामर्थ्य रूपा शक्तिर अस्ति. सो वन्नी, द वर्ड वन्नी एंड द पदार्थ वन्नी, द फायर इटसेल्फ, वन्नी हे स्वसंबंध पदार्थ दाह जनन सामर्थ्य रूपा शक्तिर अस्ति. सो द कैपेसिटी टू बर्न इज देयर इन द फायर. And that kind of fire comes to mind when you hear the word vanni, agnihi, any of these words. So, yatha vannihe swasambandha padartha daha janana samarthya rupa shakti rasti tatha shrotu shravanendriya sanyukta shabdasya swasambandha artha jnana janana samarthya rupa shakti rasti. Just like the vanni has the capacity to burn things. Where is this capacity to burn? It is there in the vanni itself. Similarly, the word and meaning are also connected, and that rests in the word itself. That is the shakti. So, an example is given there, taking the word vanni. Now, agnau dahakatva shakti vat jale sechakatvam dahashantikaratvam churna pindi karakatvam ityadi samarthyam asti. Then there are multiple capacities, shaktis in jala. So jala has sechakatvam, dahashantikaratvam, churna pindi karakatvam. All these kinds of shaktis are there in jala. It can wetten something, it can, you know, if there is, it can, you know, put off fire also, dahashanti. Or, you know, if there is, if something is burning, so you drink water when there is burning within, that is due to agni within. So, Daha Shantikaratvam is a Shakti which is there in Jala. Churna Pindi Karakatvam. So, you take some powder of mud, you add water to it. So, water has the capacity to convert this mud into a lump of clay. So, this kind of Shakti is there within the Padartha, Jala. Jala Padartha. Tat Samarthyam Eva Shakti Rityuchyate. That is Shakti. So similarly, that kind of shakti is there. It is similar. It is not the same shakti, of course. Similar shakti is there in the pada also. So the shakti is explained. What is really shakti? So that shakti, what we discuss as shakti, in the case of padartha, similarly, such kind of shakti is there even in pada. That shakti in the pada is what reveals the meaning. So shakti is talked about as resting in the padartha also, and some similar kind of shakti which can reveal the meaning is there in the pada also. That is a comparison here. Evam sarva padartheshu swasva karya jananukulam samarthyam asti tat samarthyam eva shaktiriti shruti siddhantah. So whatever is the capacity to do something, that is resting in the padartha, that is called a shakti. Similarly, that capacity to reveal the meaning is resting in the word itself, that is also called a shakti. So padartha shakti, pada shakti, vanni shakti, and then vanni pada shakti. Vanni pada reveals to vanni padartha meaning, that shakti is resting in vanni pada. The dahakatva shakti is not there in the pada, it is there in the padartha. So vanni padartha gata dahakatva shakti is there. So shaktis are there in words and there in the objects also. Or rather, the way there are shaktis in the object, similarly there are shaktis in the word also. This is the explanation given here. Ayam artha manasi nischayena dharyaha nayayika adi siddhantastu heyaha. So the guru is telling the shishya, you understand what this shakti is first, and then don't go to Nayayika Siddhanta, you drop their ideas. In passing, if you understand it, because this is what they talk about, if you have heard about it or you come across it, do not hold on to those, drop those ideas. Hold on to what is this Shakti really in the case of Pada revealing the Padartha, because Mahavakya understanding is going to take place only in this way. Further, Akshepa is there. So this, there is an objection. Varna samudayatmaka pada pada atirikta shaktya bhavad ishwarichchayava shakti. So Nayayika objects to this. He says varna samudayatmaka pada atirikta shaktya bhavad ishwarichchayava shakti. Why does Nayayika say that ishwara shakti is the ishwarichcha is the shakti, not the padagata shakti? What is this pada? He says varna samudayatmaka pada. If you look at pada, what is the pada? Ghata is ghakara, akara, takara, akara. Ghata. Now you are saying there is a shakti in this ghata. Where is it? Ghata pada. Ghata pada is akshara samudaya, varna samudaya. So vyanjana and swara put together, you will have a pada. So varna samudaya is pada ghata. Where is the shakti which tells you that the sakala kalasha roopa jnana? Where is that shakti in this pada? I don't see anything else. So the Nayayika objects, and through this objection he says that Ishara Ichha is this shakti, because there is nothing else called as shakti in the pada other than varna samudaya. So varna samudayatmaka pada atirikta, there is no other shakti. So pada itself, you say it is shakti. What is resting in the pada? There is nothing else. Varnas come together, then there is some shakti. How does it come in? What is this? It is Ishwara, Ishwara Ichha. Vannehe swarupatiriktataya shaktir nama na upalabhyate. Now Nayayika is using actually what Vedantin uses for them as well. Here he says vannehe swarupatiriktataya shaktir nama na upalabhyate. In the case of shakti, he is talking about that. But he takes guna as a separate thing resting in the guni. There he does not use this logic. He says that guna and guni are different. And to that we have objected. Earlier we had seen this. We say there is nothing called as guna separate from guni. We have never seen them separately. therefore they are together. And not only together, they are one and the same, you cannot differentiate. But this is a Vedanta argument where we go to Siddhanta. Where we are discussing Siddhanta as to Jnana is the Swarupa. However, in this context of Shakti, Nayayika has forgotten that Guna-Guni difference and he uses the Vedantic tactic and he says, Vanyehe Swarupa Atiriktataya Shaktir Nama Na Upalabhyate. We have not experienced anything called as Shakti. We don't know of anything. We don't cognize any called any Shakti separate from the Vanni itself, which is Dahaka Samarthyam. Daha Hetu Bhutam Vanni Nishta Samarthyame Vanne Shakti Riti Purvoktam Nayuktam. So that which is a capacity to burn, Siddhanti saying that that capacity is resting in the Vanni itself. Vannau Daha Hetuttvam Kevalam Asti. Such kind of Shakti isn't there. Vannau Daha Hetuttvam Kevalam Asti. Aprasiddham Samarthyam Vannau Kalpayitva Tasya Daha Karanatva Kalpana Agni Nishta Prasiddha Dahaka Daha Karanatva Parityagachan Kinchid Apyasti Prayojanam. So Nayayika, this may be Nayayika or it can be someone else also. So we can take someone else also because Nayayika considers Guna and Guni as different. However, since the Akshepa is Ishwara Ichha, he has taken cue from Nayayika who says Shakti is Ishwara Ichha, not Padanishtha Shakti. And this is not valid in the example also where the Padartha Shakti is being talked about. We have talked about Padartha Shakti and similar Shakti is being said to be there in the Pada. Now he is refuting the example itself. He says there is nothing called as Shakti, which is Daha Samarthyam. The capacity of fire to burn is not seen separately from fire. So Daha Hetu Bhutam Vanninishta Samarthyam Eva Vanne Shakti Riti Purvoktam Na Yuktam. It is not valid. Why? Vannau Daha Hetuttvam Kevalam Asti. There is only Daha Hetu in Vanni. There is no Shakti in Vanni. Aprasiddham Samarthyam. This Samarthya capacity to burn is something that is not well known. So why do you use something which is not well known and use that an example to prove that Pada also has Shakti? This is the Aropa. So Vannau Kalpayatva Tasya Daha Karanatva Kalpanat Agni Nishta Prasiddha Daha Karanatva Parityagachana Kinchid Apyasti Prayojanam Yathadrishtante Agnau Shaktir Namana Kachid Atirikta Bhati Tatha Darshtantike Pade Api Akshara Samudayatmaka Pada Swarupa Atirikta Shaktir Na Ibhati. Just like you don't see some well-known Shakti in the Agni which is the capacity to burn, this is what you say. Similarly, there is nothing separately visible in the case of Pada also. It's an Akshara Samudaya. There is no specific Shakti. So your example itself is wrong. What to talk about the exemplified? It won't work. This is the Aropa. Tadrusha Shaktyangikare Prayojanam cha Nasti. You don't need to. See, this Hetu, it is a Karana for burning. That's all we can say. This is what is visible. If I put wood in fire, the fire burns the wood. So fire is Karana for the burning. That much I can agree upon because this is Anubhava Siddha. Now if you talk about some Shakti within the Agni, that I do not agree because it is not well known. It is not needed also. There is no specific Prayojana also. Similarly, I do not agree with your Shakti conclusion about the Pada also. There is no Shakti in the Pada, just like there is no Shakti in the Padartha also. This is the Aropa. Tasmat Nyaya Mata Ukta Ishwara Ichha Rupa Shakti Reva Yukta. Therefore, you have to agree with Nayayika's conclusion only that Shakti is not Padagata, it is Ishwara Ichha. Ishwara Ichha is a Shakti which is well known. Ishwara has Shakti, this is well known. So we have to use what is well known and agreeable to everyone. Why? Interpret something, by doing some kalpana. Therefore, we agree with Nayayika's way out, says the middleman, or it is a Nayayika himself who establishes his own viewpoint, saying that Ishwara Ichha is this Shakti, which you consider to be Pada Shakti, there is no Pada Shakti. Purvoktakshepasya samadhanam. What is the Siddhanti's answer there? Agnyado agnyadyatirkta dahadi karya janana anukula samarthya rupa shakti sadbhava kathanam. First, the example has to be clearly established. So, Agni is a padartha which has the shakti to burn things. This is established. Guru Ruvacha, he somya sati pratibandhe jwalat jwalatapyagnina daho naiva jayate. उत्तेजक सानिध्ये तु अग्निना संयुक्त पदार्थ सत्यपि प्रतिबंधके दह्यते विना एव शक्तिं केवलाग्नेरेव दाह कारणत्वांगीकारे उत्तेजक सहित प्रतिबंधक सद्भाव दशायाम् इव प्रतिबंधक शून्यकाले इव च उत्तेजक शून्य प्रतिबंधक सद्भाव दशायाम् अपि दाहो नियमेन जायेत. सो कॉम्प्लिकेटेड एग्जांपल देयर. व्हाई दिस शक्ति हैज टू बी interpreted. In the case of the example first, Agni should be having Shakti to burn. Why? Otherwise, you will have issues. Prayojanam nasti is the aropa. First, prayojana has to be established. There is prayojana to accept Shakti in the Agni. As an example. So, sati pratibandhe jvalatapyagnina dahaha naiva jayate. So, if there is something which is obstructing the fire in some way so that someone cannot be burnt or something cannot be burnt, then there is no burning possible. So, uttejaka sanidhye tu agnina sanyukta padartha satyapi pratibandhake dayate. So, you cannot light or you cannot burn something when there is water. When there is water, you cannot burn something. Agni is there, but you cannot burn it. Why? Because water is an obstacle to burning. Is a pratibandha there. Now, when uttejaka sanidhye tu agnina sanyukta padartha satyapi pratibandhake dayate. Now, wet wood is there. Fire cannot burn wet wood if the wood is a lot, has a lot of water, is wet so much, it cannot be burnt by small fire. Let's say there is little water in the wood, still a huge fire can burn it. It may be smoky for a while, but then still the wood can be consumed in fire, it can be burnt. So Shakti is there in Vanni. That Shakti is not sufficient when there is pratibandha, which is stronger. Thereby, Shakti is inferred to be there in fire. Otherwise, either it would burn all the time if it is Ishwara Ichha. Ishwara Ichha is what? If you say Shakti is Ishwara Ichha, what is that Ishwara Ichha? Shakti in the case of Padartha. Let this Padartha Agni burn all kinds of fuel. Or let it burn anything and everything in its presence. Does it so really happen? It cannot burn wet wood. So if Ishwara Ichha, is it failing? It isn't failing. So what we have to say is that there is Shakti in Agni which is not sufficient to burn wood completely immersed in water. However, if the fire is huge and the wood is a little wet, then that Pratibandha being there also, the fire burns. What is the reason? The Shakti within the fire is sufficient. The obstacles are not going to block that burning. Thereby, Shakti has to be accepted. Prayojanam nasti has been said. Prayojanam asti eva. Vina eva shaktim kevalagneer eva dahakaranatvangikare uttejaka sahita pratibandhaka sadbhavadashayam eva pratibandhaka shunyakale eva cha uttejaka shunya pratibandhaka sadbhavadashayam api daho niyamena jayat. So what will happen in that case if you don't agree with Shakti? Shakti isn't there, then what will happen? Keval agneer eva daha karanatva. You say that karanatva is there. You just accept karanatva. I explained Ishvara Shakti, which is the conclusion he has landed on. But then what has he said? There is Agni is the karana for burning. That much alone you accept, not Shakti. Then Agni is there, so karanatva is there. Daha karanatva is there. Now this Agni, in its presence, Kevala Agni Reva Daha Karanatva Angikare Uttejaka Sahita Pratibandaka Sadbhava Dashayam. There is fire, which is Uttejaka. Then along with it, there is Pratibandaka Sadbhava also. Wet water, you know, wet wood or something, which opposes this burning, is also there. Pratibandaka Shunya Kale Iva. So when there is no wetness in wood, Uttejaka Shunya Pratibandaka Sadbhava Dashayam Api. If the fire is there, but there is not, it is not flaming. Well, little bit of fire is there, and then Pratibandaka Sadbhava, there is lot of water in the wood, so it is completely immersed. In all the three cases, what should happen? The wood should burn. Daho niyamena jayeta. Why? Because daha karanatva is there. Whether the fire is flaming or not, fire is there. When the fire is flaming, also fire is there. With water, without water in the wood, fire is still there. In all the three cases, does the wood burn? It doesn't. So karana is there. Why is karya not there? So this karana analysis, karana inference is not sufficient. You have to agree with some shakti, whereby that shakti is opposed to by obstacles. Whichever is stronger will win over. So daha karani bhuta kevalagne he tadrusha tadrusha maybe. So daha karani bhuta kevalagne tadrusha pratibandaka sadbhava dashayapi sattva asman matetu agni nishta shakte shakti sahita agneer va daha hetutva abhyupagamat nayam doshaha. In your case, there is an issue because in the Siddhanti tells the Nayayika that Agni has daha karanatva. If that much alone is accepted and Shakti is not accepted separately, then in all cases Agni should burn the wood. But it doesn't happen so. Asman matetu, in our case Shakti is accepted, therefore Agni Nishta Shakti Shakti Sahita Agni Rva. Either you say Agni Nishta Shakti is there or Shakti Sahita Agni is there. Daha hetutva abhyupagamat nayam doshaha. We don't have any issue because we can explain that the Shakti is not sufficient in this case because there is Pratibandha. Na kevala agnehe daha hetutvam asman mate pratibandaka sadbhava dashayam pratibandakena na agnir nasho va tirodhanam va sambhavati kintu agni nishta shaktir nasho va tirodhanam va bhavati. So what is happening there is shakti nasha or tirodhana is taking place based on the example whether the pratibandha is strong, is present, is not there, or is strong. Tasma dahetu bhutagni shaktehe shakti vishishtagnirva abhavadeva na daho jayate yatra tu pratibandaka samipe uttejakam nasti tatra pratibandakaha agni shaktir nasham va tirodhanam va karoti uttejakantu purna punarapi shaktir utpattim avirbhavam va karoti tasmat satyapi pratibandake uttejaka mahatmyat dahaka shakti shakti vishishtagnirva sadbhava daho janyate. So I explain that whichever is stronger will win over. So we can explain this based on the shakti and pratibandaka analysis of which is stronger. So shakti will be subsided or shakti will burn the wood, and it is agni nishtha. Ittham pratibandakena vinashyanti uttejakena punarutpadyamana cha agnehe shaktir eva daha karanam. So what is the cause for burning? It is the shakti, which may be sufficient, may be less, which is subsided, or which may be more flaming. कार्य विरोधी यत्तत् प्रतिबंधकम् इत्युच्यते. व्हाट इज प्रतिबंधक? विच इज कार्य विरोधी, विच डज नॉट इन द केस ऑफ द फायर, विच डज नॉट लेट द फायर बर्न. बर्निंग इज द कार्य. दैट कार्य इज नॉट पॉसिबल व्हेन द वॉटर इज प्रेजेंट और देयर आर सम अदर यू नो वेदास शास्त्रास टॉक अबाउट सम मणि ऑल्सो, पर्टिकुलर मणि which is used by people to protect themselves from being burned. So that has some magical power. When it is present, then it is a pratibandhaka to burning. And this is used in lot of shastras to describe it. So pratibandhaka I explained as jala, but in shastra what is talked about is this mani, which when present does not allow the fire to burn. So it's used for protection. कार्य विरोधी यत्तत् प्रतिबंधकम् इत्युच्यते, विच इज अपोज्ड टू द कार्य. इन द एग्जांपल केस अपोज्ड टू बर्निंग इज कॉल्ड एज प्रतिबंधक. प्रतिबंधक सद्भावेपि यत् कार्य साधकम् तद् उत्तेजकम् इति कथ्यते. व्हाट इज उत्तेजक इन दिस एग्जांपल? उत्तेजक इज दैट विच इवन इफ देर इज प्रतिबंधक इट इज स्ट्रॉन्गर. इन दिस केस द फ्लेमिंग फायर यू नो विच हैज ग्रोन इन टू फ्लेम्स, दैट काइंड ऑफ फायर इज उत्तेजक. अग्नि विषय प्रतिबंधकत्वं उत्तेजकत्वं च मणिमंत्र औषधादीनां. सो देयर इज मणिमंत्र एंड औषध. देयर आर दीज वेरियस टाइप्स व्हिच आर यूज्ड टू प्रोटेक्ट फायर, सॉरी प्रोटेक्शन फॉर प्रोटेक्शन फ्रॉम फायर. सो वेदर इट इज अ पर्टिकुलर मणि मंत्र यूज्ड और औषधास इन द केस ऑफ यू नो आयुर्वेद ऑल्सो प्रोटेक्ट यूर सेल्फ फ्रॉम. अ कॉमन एग्जाम्पल इन मॉडर्न एग्जाम्पल वुड बी एन एंटासिड, something of that sort. So whatever is it, whether you use aushadhi, whether you use mantra or whether you use mani, in the case of fire it is going to be pratibandhaka to fire. It will not let fire do its karya. So mani mantra aushadhadina madhye yasya sanidhyat daho na jayate sa pratibandhaka, yasya sanidhyat satyapi pratibande daho jayate sa uttejakah. Anyway, it is very clear, I think pratibandhaka and uttejaka is clear as to when something is there, then fire cannot act, that is pratibandhaka. When that pratibandha is there, but still the fire can burn, that is uttejakah. He somya agnau iva. So I'll just finish this para. He somya agnau iva jaladi sakala padarthesopi sthitam tatkarya jananukulam shaktim janihi. विना तु शक्तिम न केनापि कारणेन किमपि कार्यं जन्यते. सो एक्सटेंडिंग दिस एग्जांपल टू द एग्जेम्प्लीफाइड, जस्ट लाइक पदार्थ हैज शक्तिस इन द केस ऑफ अग्नि, अग्नि हैज दाहकत्व शक्ति. सिमिलरली द पद अग्नि हैज द शक्ति टू रिवील द पदार्थ अग्नि. सो द वर्ड फायर द वर्ण समूह ऑल्सो पद रिवील्स अ पर्टिकुलर मीनिंग of that fire which really burns. So the word fire, agni, reveals the real fire out there in the world which can burn. That is the shakti within the word fire. Agna viva jaladi sakala padarteshopi. Just like this word agni has the capacity to reveal the padartha agni, similarly jala etc. all these other words also have samarthya, shakti. तत्त कार्य जननानुकूलं शक्तिं जानीहि विना तु शक्तिं न केनापि कारणेन किमपि कार्यं जन्यते. विदाउट कारण यू कैन नॉट हैव कार्य. इत्थं शक्तेः प्रयोजनं निरूपितं. सो शक्ति डज नॉट हैव प्रयोजन एडिशनली, दैट हैज बीन रिफ्यूटेड एंड दैट ऑब्जेक्शन हैज बीन आंसर्ड बाय एक्सप्लेनिंग देयर इज प्रयोजन. अदरवाइज दिस उत्तेजक एंड प्रतिबंधक कैन नॉट बी अंडरस्टूड. इन द केस ऑफ प्रतिबंध बीइंग देयर नॉट बीइंग देयर और उत्तेज बीइंग देयर नॉट बीइंग देयर, इन ऑल केसेस द कारण शुड लीड टू कार्य, दैट डजंट हैपन. अग्नि स्वरूपातिरिक्त शक्ति. सो अग्नि स्वरूपातिरिक्त शक्ति ही नास्ति इति आक्षेप समाधान रूपतया तादृश शक्ति सद्भाव विषय अनुभव प्रदर्शते. इफ यू से देयर इज नो सच अनुभव, देन दैट इज ऑल्सो आंसर्ड एज टू शक्ति बीइंग देयर. इदानीं प्रतिबंधक सद्भाव दशायां प्रज्वलत्यप्यग्नौ शक्तिः दाह सामर्थ्यम नास्ति पश्चात उत्तेजक सद्भाव दशायाम शक्त्यंतरम जायते इति शक्ति सद्भाव विषय का अनुभव टीका टीकरनाथादि सिद्ध पुरुष विनोद चेष्टा पश्यताम सर्वेषामस्ति तादृश लोकानुभव केन शक्यते अपलपितुम अनुमित प्रमात्मक अनुमिति प्रमात्मकः अयम अनुभव न केनापि प्रकारेण बाधितुं शक्यते इत्थं सिद्धांतानुसारेण शक्ति स्वरूपं तत्प्रमाणं च निरूपितम् सो द एग्जांपल हैज बीन गिवन वी हैव सीन वन एग्जांपल इन दी अर्लियर आल्सो सो शक्ति सद्भाव विषय का अनुभव सो वी हैव ऑल हैव दिस अनुभव आल्सो यू आर नॉट विलिंग टू लुक इनटू इट इफ यू एनालाइज इट देन such anubhava is definitely there based on what is present what is not present the karana leads to karya in the tippana uttejaka has been explained there is there anything yeah so pratibandaki bhuta mani mantra aushadayah tesham agni nishta dah shakti nashakatva tirobhavatvadayah tatho tejaki bhuta mani mantra aushadayah तेषां अग्निनिष्ठ दाह शक्ति उत्पादकत्वादि आविर्भावकत्वादयश्च टीकरनाथादि सिद्ध पुरुषेषु प्रसिद्धम् सो दिस प्रसिद्धम् इज प्रसिद्धम् इन द केस ऑफ दोज हु हैव स्टडीड दोज शास्त्रास् इफ वी डोंट नो इट वी डोंट नो दिस प्रसिद्धता सो दिस प्रसिद्ध इज टॉक्ड अबाउट दिस टीकरनाथ इत्यादि ऑल दैट is in particular context we are not sure of the context but what has been said is pratibandaki bhuta mani mantra aushadha mani mantra and aushadhas are very well known in shastras where they will protect the person from agni so they are pratibandaka then what do they do so tesham agni nishta daha shakti that daha shakti which is there in the agni that shakti they overpower whether it is mani or mantra so thereby nashakatva they can destroy the agni also through mantra they can destroy agni also mantra ityadi or they can reduce tirobhava is possible so varying results are possible based on the power of the mantra also so mantra shakti mani shakti ityadi shaktis oppose the shakti in the agni thereby agni nishta shakti has to be accepted it is anubhava siddha to those who have used mantra mani or those who have shraddha in the shastra that talks about mani mantra aushadhis as protecting kavachas from agni dahakatva then tatha uttejaki bhuta mani mantra aushadayah then there are some mani mantra and aushadhis even to increase the fire also so between enemies when they are fighting one may be using some mani some mantra some aushadhi to protect the other may be using to make the weapon more powerful agni so agni bana whatever they have so with mantra and manis and with aushadhis one may be making his shakti stronger to attack the enemy the other enemy may be protecting himself with different mantra different manis and aushadhis whichever has more shakti will overpower the other that's all it is tesham agni nishta dah shakti utpadakatva so the shakti which is there in the agni to increase that to bring it out to increase that fueling it further and further avirbhava all these are possible using the uttejaka and protection can be there by using the pratibandha so you increase the pratibandha or you increase the daha uttejaka using whatever tools you have but shakti has to be accepted for that reason and it is prasiddha so anubhava cannot be denied and that cannot be the basis to counter that prayojanam nasti with prayojanam nasti this is the idea and thereby it can be extended to the pada shakti also and where is the shakti it is not ishvara ichha it is that shakti which is there in the pada itself so that is the topic which has been concluded then shakti vishe matantara khandanam what do other darshanikas talk about this shakti that has to be refuted and then you land on what siddhanta has said and then see whether this shakti pada shakti is sufficient to reveal the meaning in case of mahavakya or you need lakshana
We'll stop here.
सुकन्नित्यं सप्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूपे अधिष्ठानं बुद्धिबोध्यं बुद्धेर् दृक्यत्तु निर्वपारं सर्ववेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं तदेव अन्नमत्तु निश्चितामतिः तत्सत्. एनी क्वेश्चंस? नमस्ते.